Good morning, what's up? Today is 14th Feb, it's Valentine's Day. I thought I'd talk about the thing I love the most, which is this country. Now, it seems to me that there are multiple variations of Indian history jo mein padhaye jaate hain. Which means ki kisi ne 10th tak kuch padha hai, kisi ne kuch aur padha hai, kisi ne kuch aur padha hai. Aur jab aap bade hote hain and you reach into the real world, what happens is यू स्टार्ट रियलाइजिंग कि जो मेरा वर्जन जो मैंने पढ़ा था हिस्ट्री का वो ज़रूरी नहीं है कि पूरी तरीके से सच हो या पूरी तरीके से गलत हो. आई मीन दिस इज एग्जैक्टली वॉट वी आर विटनेसिंग टूडे इन इंडिया वेन वी सी पीपल हु से थिंग्स लाइक वो हिस्टोरियन बायस्ड है या वो हिस्टोरियन लेफ्टी है या वो हिस्टोरियन राइट विंग है, वो सिर्फ हिंदुत्व के बारे में लिखता है, वो सिर्फ लेफ्ट की बढ़ाई करता है. मतलब अगर आप देखें Romila Thapar type person, like a lot of people at least on the Indian web space have web space, a fuck all word to use, but yeah, a lot of people on the Indian online community believe that Romila Thapar is an extremely left leaning or completely Marxist sort of historian, and maybe it's correct. I have read like only फ्रेगमेंट्स ऑफ वॉट शी इज रिटन बिकॉज आई बिलोंग टू द महाराष्ट्र बोर्ड, तो मैंने एनसीईआरटी की किताबें नहीं पढ़ी. हाउएवर दिस थिंग विच वेर एवरीबडी हैज अ डिफरेंट वर्जन ऑफ हिस्ट्री, आई बिलीव इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ इंडियन कल्चरल एमनीजिया. एंड व्हाट आई मीन बाय दैट इज लाइक वी डोंट रियली हैव अ स्ट्रॉन्ग कलेक्टेड आइडिया ऑफ व्हाट इंडिया इज. अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट पीपल हैव लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट आइडियाज एंड आई डू थिंक दैट this particular thing has been made use of by Indian politicians right from 1947. मतलब जब से आज़ादी मिली है या उससे कुछ साल पहले से ही अलग अलग political parties ने इंडिया के historic events को appropriate करना शुरू किया. किसी ने अपना version बताया, किसी ने अपना version बताया. What I'm going to try and do through this series is I'm going to try and just talk about the things that have happened and try to figure out what is correct and what is wrong, because I'm sort of sick of the whole Twitter culture where everybody seems to know everything for some reason, and I think there is a big virtue in not knowing things. What I mean by that is jo maine abhi kaha ki India ke itne sare histories hain, it all comes from a great repository of knowledge that this country has since last 4000 years or so, जो कि हमने बनाई है, वो ओरली पास डाउन हुई है, काफ़ी कुछ लिखित में पास डाउन हुआ है. बट पीपल ऑन ट्विटर दे सीम टू क्लेम एवरीथिंग, दे जस्ट नो एवरीथिंग, दे आर लाइक मुझको पता है तू चुतिया. दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ एन एटीट्यूड आई थिंक सॉर्ट ऑफ नीड्स टू गो. व्हाट नीड्स टू कम इन इज अ जेन्युइन क्यूरियोसिटी फॉर द कंट्री. एंड या बेसिकली That's what I want to do with like the upcoming videos. And मतलब जैसे कि एक छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल है, मुझे ये कल शाम को पता चला. एंड I am re-reading a book by Francis Fukuyama called The Origins of Political Order. और काफ़ी इंटरेस्टिंग बुक है, हो सकेगा तो मैं आगे भी डिस्कस करूँगा इस बुक के बारे में. What it does is it traces the histories of multiple countries. Now one of the things I've always felt is the fact that India has got a lot of problems going on right now, political and cultural, especially cultural, economic obviously, but no matter where we are right now, I think we are still a better country than China, which has no problems killing its citizens and neutralizing, as they call it, neutralizing the people who are infected by viruses and getting rid of dissidents. Does it happen in India? Yes. Does it happen at the scale at which it happens in China? I don't know, maybe it does not, but it's too powerful a country for anybody to talk about. And I've been trying to read more about China, I've been trying to read more about the relationship between India and China, and the book that I was referring to was Francis Fukuyama's Origins of Political Order. What I realized while reading Origins of Political Order is that एक पॉइंट आता है हिस्ट्री पे जहाँ पे इंडिया की और चाइना की हिस्ट्रीज डाइवर्ज होनी शुरू हो जाती हैं. मतलब एक समय तक वी वर ऑल ट्राइबल सोसाइटीज़, But 8 point ke baad the histories start diverging, which means that China did not develop a priestly class while we developed a Varna system. What it did was, at least in China, the king became somebody who was almost like a god, and the god could wage warfare on anybody. However, in India, there were, like, above the kings there were the Brahmins, and this seems to be like one of the outflow effects from Brahminism, that to take part in a war, the how do I put it very precisely, the king had to take the permission of the Brahmin or the priestly class, which sort of kept India's invading tendencies in check. So that is the reason why India actually did not develop what you would call an extremely violent culture. And I know there are multiple caveats to this, and then there are multiple theories which will come and say, oh, that's not the case, India has a very violent past. I'm saying as compared to China. And that is something that has really sort of caught my attention, that India had a stratified system, and that is, and it was not a good system, no doubt about it. It was a horrible system. We are still suffering from the repercussions from it. I mean, we see that sort of stratification in society even now, once you go out of the cities, or even in cities to an extent. However, what the system did back in the day, around 2000 years ago, was it kept the kings in check. And this, for me, is a very interesting thing. Just from the perspective of a person who's trying to understand this country and its relation to the countries around it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read more about it. If I find something interesting, I'm going to tell you. If you think that there is something interesting that you can add to this idea, why is it that two countries developed so differently at the same time? It would be like a fun journey to be on and explore this whole subcontinent together. So I'm going to finish my morning coffee, and I'm going to come back again tomorrow trying to record something else, trying to talk about something else, something that I find interesting in the context of India itself. I'm also rereading an essay by Salman Rushdie called Step Across This Line. It's a speech or it's an essay, I forgot, but it's like a really, really long piece. It's about immigration. I will talk about it hopefully tomorrow. In the meantime, ciao.